So we're finally on our way to Sweden. It's Friday the 8th of May. It's just gone past 12 o'clock. And this little one with her head out, who's been with us for the last 8 weeks, is going to be on her way to Sweden to our new forever home. And I'm driving. So myself and another guy, Andy, who I haven't yet met. Just over about 2,500 miles. We'll be alternating driving. It's going to take us about 2 days to get there. 47 dogs in total. There's going to be 30 in one. And she's skipping all over the place. So 30 small ones in one van and 17 larger ones in the other. And I'm driving the other one. And I've no idea what the next 96 hours is going to take. 48 hours. 2 days to get there, 2 days to get back, because we'll be driving back the whole way. But anyway, why are we doing it? Well, because we can't look after our own rescue dogs here. We have to rely on Sweden to take them for us. But that's a story for another day. Basically, I've got to get to the pound, to Ashton, to meet Camilla and Andy and the others, get all the dogs together, and take it from there and say goodbye to this little lunatic here. Say goodbye, Amy. Bye, Amy. 8 weeks. She still never learned her name. See you later. Bye-bye. I got him. Go, Karina. Gary.
Hi, nice to
meet
you.
Hi, pleased to meet you.
This is Marie.
Oh, Marie, hi, how are you?
Hi.
Hello, puppy. Hello, Amy.
Sorry,
nice.
You go to your daddy.
Yeah. Okay. There's my girl. Okay, Peppy.
Right, let's look.
This is Andy, is it? I am indeed. How are you, sir? We're going to be here a long time. Gorgeous.
Stuff like that, Andy. Come on, you. Up you go. Good boy.
Gorgeous. You're not into country music, are you?
Fucking you're not, are you?
No.
Oh, right.
That's the only thing I give a shit about. I was kind of joking with myself. I says, I don't give a shite what music's on, as long as it's not fucking country and western. This is Andy, Custom Rescue Ireland.
Yep.
And doing the same old thing, taking a load of doggies over, picking up a couple and bringing them back. So it's a long old journey. We'll be back again. Chat to you later. First ferry from Dublin to Holyhead. So really, we haven't even really started. I'm looking over there. So we haven't really even started the journey yet. Andy's kipping down, because we've got a cabin. Andy's kipping down there. The two girls are in another cabin. I'm not bothering me whole. So basically it is, we're expected to take us about 10-11 hours to get from Holyhead to Harwich, which is where we get the ferry to Holland. Normal driving time, it's only about 6 hours, but because we're going to have to continue to keep stopping to walk the dogs and clean up after them if need be, we have to do that twice, and with near on 50 dogs,
That's probably going to take us a couple of hours each time. So a 6-hour journey is probably going to take us around 10 hours. We arrive in Holyhead around 20 past 6. So we're expecting to be in Harwich around 4 o'clock tomorrow morning for the 8 o'clock ferry to Holland. That's it. So, yeah, mad old journey. We're only after starting. It was Amy settling in. She's been quiet. She's been really, really good. I hate leaving her. I am going to miss her, even though she's completely fecking mad. But, you know, she's a beautiful little dog. And it's just good to know that all near 50 dogs are going to fantastic families in Sweden. It's a pity we have to send our dogs to Sweden. Something wrong there, but anyway, that's a story for another time. So anyway, that's it. Chat to you all later. Bye.
And then the bigger ones, more active ones, can get to a few more minutes instead.
So just doing one at a time, is it?
Yeah, one at a time. And if they don't know each other, they can't meet each other.
We'll social distance them.
Yeah, good. And I was thinking I can stay inside, and if any dog in the street needs to be seen, I will clean it.
Yep.
We
take dogs in and out, we always have to go close.
So.
Okay. Oh, I've got one here.
Okay.
Hello. Good boy. Is it coming out? Is it pups? Come on. Oh my word. Hello, cutie. Hello, cutie. Oh my word. Go on, gorgeous. Yo. Hello, little snifters. Hello, little snifters. Hello, little snifters. Oh, cutie, cutie, cutie. Come on. Where are you going? Where are you going? Where are you going? Where are you going? Come on. You're supposed to be going for a walk. You're supposed to be going for a walk. You're supposed to be going for a walk. What are you doing? Oh, you're gorgeous. You're gorgeous. You're gorgeous. You're so gorgeous. You're going mad. This one's gone mad. She's a nutter.
Hey,
Bobby. Where you going? Where you going? Oh, no, rubbing the belly. rubbing her belly. Come on, you little fool. Come on, you little nutter. Hello, Peggy. Little Peggy. Okay. Come on.
Oh,
no problem, no worries. Come on, puppy. He's all backed up. He can't get it out. Oh, poor thing. He can't get it out. It's all right, puppy. Take your time. Take your time. Happens to us all.
So you can see, this is our first stop. We've only got about 20 minutes past Holyhead, or outside Holyhead. So it's still 20 to 8. So we've been here maybe half an hour, 30, 40 minutes so far, walking the dog. So at the moment, I've got this little one who's all clogged up and has just had the last biggest nightmare trying to relieve himself. But this is first walk for all the puppies, nearly 50, 48 or something like that. So, but this is what needs to be done. First stop, little walk, pee, poo, whatever needs to be done. And then we'll be on our way again. Okay, chat to you later. Bye bye. Okay. Come on, this one. All right. Come on. Oh, Jesus. Come on. Oh, fucking hell. Hey, little puppy. Come on. Okay. No. These are a f***ing nightmare, man. Good night. This is... F***ing Jesus. Right, hold on. No, you need to come this way. Come on. Please pee or poo or do something. You ain't shitting, you're walking. Say hello to Auntie Maya. Okay, this is tough. So we've been doing this about an hour now, about an hour so far. We haven't even got, I don't think we've even hit half yet. This is tough. It's 8 o'clock at night now. So it's 8 o'clock. We got here just after eight. We got here just after seven. And I don't even know how many dogs have walked at this stage, or the others. And we're still on the same first van. Now there is a lot more in the first van than the second, but this is hard work, and we have another one to do before we get to Harwich. And and then obviously that's an 8-9 hour ferry, and then over to Holland, and it's like a 6 hour drive in Holland, but no doubt there's going to be another couple of stops again. So it's going to be four times before, we're going to do this at least four times before we even get to Denmark. And then between Denmark and Sweden, or the stop-off in Sweden, that's another, I think, five-hour drive. So clearly we're going to be doing it again. This is not easy. I don't know how they do this.
you know, I'm only driving. And you listen to those, the cries and the yelps and the screams of these puppies. These, I say puppies, they're all puppies. Some of them are a lot older, but you know, they're all puppies to me. But how they can do this constantly, day in, day out. I mean, they make this trip. Now, I'm yet to be corrected, but they make this trip like every other week, like countless times a year. How many feckin' dogs do we send away? It's insane. How many dogs get abandoned? Sort yourselves out. Steak. Alright, I'm gonna be pissed off now. Still waiting for this one to do a number two. Done a number one, but it's still backed up looking for number two. So, see y'all later. Bye bye.
Hello. Hello. Come on. Hello. Oh. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay, my little puppy. You're a little puppy.
Oh, now you're livening up.
Just an ultrasound, and he said, don't ask me to count them, he said, but it disappeared. So fingers crossed.
The bowl is empty. The bowl is empty. There is no food in the bowl. The bowl is empty. The bowl is empty.
Did you have dinner?
Oh, little puppy.
Oh, you are burping me in the ear. That is so nice. That is so nice.
Okay, it's now 10 to 10. We got here at about just after 7. So nearly 3 hours walking dogs. Doing nothing but walking dogs.
I'm picking up shit.
And so I got to Ashton around 7:30. I think Andy was there a bit earlier. So we're talking about, oh sorry, what am I saying? I don't even know what I'm saying. 12:30. Half 12. So between 12 and 12:30. So in about 8 hours, we've travelled a total of about 20 kilometres, because we've only 30 kilometres, because we're only about 20 mile outside Holyhead. So we basically haven't even travelled yet. So we have a 6 hour trip to go now. As I said, we've been on the road about 8 hours so far, and we'll chat again in, who knows, if we're still here. All right, keep it country. Andy, say goodbye.
See you guys.
How's things?
Oh, good. Hey, cool.
That's what time are we now? 10 to 4. 10 to 4 in the morning.
Getting ready for the next walk.
Next walk, another 3 hour walk. Okay, this is what we do. So it's our 10 to 4. We've arrived in Harwich. We're about 10, 15 minutes ahead of the two girls, so we're just waiting for them to catch up with us. And then we'll go and do walk number two. So the last time took us nearly 3 hours, so hopefully a little bit less this time, and be on the ferry for I think 7-8 o'clock. So I've been up so far about 23 hours. Yeah, it wasn't too bad. A couple of Red Bull, got me going. I swapped over with Andy about, what was it, about 2 o'clock, something like that.
Give or take, yeah.
Yeah, so Andy carried on driving until about 2, and then we did a quick 5-minute flip around, down a couple of Red Bulls, and here we are. So, yeah, as I said, 10 to 4. Another few hours yet before we get to the ferry, but we're going to be tied up walking dogs for 3 hours, 2-3 hours, however long it takes. So, yeah, here we go. See you later on. Rock and roll. All for the dogs. All for the dogs. Bye-bye.
Aw, Beatles.
Okay, let's get into more space, puppies, because you're walking all over each other. This way, it will free up. There we go. Not on my head. Oh no, you're tied around your leg. Oh, sweet divine Jesus. His little white face is adorable. Don't be doing that while you're done. She's having a pill. Oh, it's so gorgeous. You are gorgeous. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Now you're going to tie yourself up. So here we now. 4:45. And mad border collie pups. At least the sun is coming up. Oh, okay, this is going to be a quick one. I have to go. She's tied up. Bye-bye. Oh. This is mayhem. Okay, it's still only 10 to 5. This is crazy. Trying to walk nearly 50 dogs at this time of the morning. Here we have another one. Oh, this is the oldie of the cutie. Come on, puppy. Good girl.
Hello. 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 Wait a minute there. Come on.
Now, what are you doing in there? You're all trapped in there again. Come on. Hello, mad thing. Oh, mad thing. Look at that wacky tail. Wacky tail. You're a big boy. You're a big boy. Big pups. There's no walking that one. No. So it's 25 to 6. We're still going. And I've been injured already. That's it. Don't know. May need to hit a medic. May need to get a medic there. Might not make it out alive. Right. So, 25 to 6. Still haven't finished one round yet. And so we're out with another two. And it kind of, this was just kind of getting into a state of delusion, really. It's like, oh yeah, it just kind of gone past it now. So, yeah, anyway, chat later again. I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, come on,
you
take Orin and I'm
gonna take Rocco. Hello, Amy. Hello, my little girl. Hello, my little girl. Oh, stretchy. Good girl. Good girl. Here's my girl. Here's my girl. Here's my girl.
As long as Charlie was around, she wouldn't go too, she wouldn't stray, so. So we knew once she could keep eyesight of Charlie, she wasn't gonna do a runner. Wherever Charlie was, that's where Amy was. Okay, so it's 6:30 now. We're still going. So this time I've got Amy. 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 Still doesn't care. Just glad to be out and running around. So yeah, it's 6:30. We still have 6 dogs. So we've still 12 more to go. So another 3 dogs each. So who knows, maybe another 30 minutes. Getting tiring. I haven't slept since, I've been up since 5:00 yesterday morning. So yeah, it's 6:30 now, so 25 and a half hours. So yeah, it's another couple of hours yet, another few hours yet before we can get onto the ferry. And I might try and put my head down then. Anyway, over and out. See you later, bye-bye. Right, we're off. We're finally done. It's 7:45. So it's taken us about 13 hours to walk these dogs. Maybe not, I don't fucking know. I'm losing all track of time, and because it's been since 5:00, yeah, I've been up since 5:00 yesterday morning, and yeah, a little bit tiring. But we're on our way, we've walked all the dogs now. We got here, it was dark, now the fucking sun is splitting. So, right, talking gibberish again. That's the second walk out of, what do we reckon, 4? Can we talk about 4?
4, yeah.
And so now we're off to the ferry. It's only a couple of miles from here. Not even that. On our way to Holland. It's a long ferry. I think it's about 8-9 hours. But no doubt I'll talk more gibberish on the ferry after I've had some food and maybe sleep. Some sleep. All right, over and out. Keep a country rocking with the free world and all that. I really am losing the plot here now. Take it easy. Bye-bye. Doing it for the dogs. Yes, like black man.
Show you how to do open and close. All you have to do is just open your arms and legs at the same time and close your legs and arms at the same time to the beat. Like this. Open, close, open, close, open, close. Open.
Good morning again. It is 10:00 a.m. Saturday, I think, which means I've been up. Sorry, it's a bit. I've now been up for a total of 29 hours straight, so I'm now going to sleep because I got a cabin. We have a cabin, and so yeah, so I'm going to go try and grab a few hours sleep. It's a long sailing, about 7 hours sailing, so I think it gets in around 4 or 5 o'clock their time. So I could get about 3-4 hours sleep. If I get 3 hours sleep, rock on. Yeah, that's it really. So 29 hours straight, gonna try and get a couple of hours sleep, and we'll do the whole thing again tonight. Because yeah, once we get into Hooker Holland, we're gonna have to pull over, do all 47 dogs again. Then when we get to Germany, the port where we go to Denmark, we got to take them all out again and do them all again. I'm talking gibberish, but I'm tired. Okay. Bye-bye. Doing it for the dogs. See you it. It's just after 2:00 in the afternoon. I didn't really sleep. I couldn't. I've just drank
taken away too much caffeine over the last, whatever, since last night. And even when we got on the ferry, I just went straight in, I don't know why, and grabbed a few coffees and a few biscuits. So I just couldn't sleep. So I'm going to be lying here for maybe 3 hours. I just kind of, whatever. I think we get into Holland around 4 o'clock our time, so in a couple of hours, less than 2 hours. So I'm just going to get up, I'm going to have a shower, and clean myself up, even though like in Egypt, I forgot my clothes in the van. So I'm going to be getting back into me manky jocks, and me manky socks, and me manky t-shirt, and me manky shorts. But considering the fact I'm going to be lifting 15, 20 dogs out of the 47, ugh, what does it matter? Anyway, it is what it is. I'm just going to get up and shower and go back up to the lounge and the driver's lounge because there's complimentary coffee. And just keep chugging more coffee and more biscuits. Doing it for the dogs. People stopped abandoning the dogs. We wouldn't have to do this. Charities wouldn't have to do this. Why? There's just something wrong here. Talking gibberish again. This is going on way too long. 4.5 minutes. This will be cut. I'll be cutting this. Bye bye. Come on. Come on. Puppy. So, still at it. It's going to 5 to 5. I don't know how many dogs we've walked so far. This one, he's had his number one and number two, but he had them fairly quickly. So I'm going to give him another few minutes to just have a walk because he's an old fella. The younger ones in the lurchers, once they're done, feck him into the bloody back in again. But there's an old fella, and he's a collie. And you know what? At his age, he deserves a bit more of a walk. And he's enjoying it. And the weather's lovely, even though I'm sick and tired of this crap. So as I said earlier, I didn't get much sleep, didn't get bugger all. But I'm feeling grand. That's more caffeine. And body clock is all over the place, so it'll probably be hit me tomorrow. But anyway, that's the crack. So, yeah. So we've 47 or 48 dogs, I've actually forgotten now. And they've come from, there's like literally, the charity deals with like 20 charities in Ireland, 20 rescues in Ireland, all over Ireland.
I think I've probably said this a few times now. This is rough. Basically, as Karina was saying telling me earlier, they found out about 15 years ago. They heard, I don't know how they heard, well, I suppose if they're a dog charity, so these things are known what happens in other countries. I'm going to walk this fella back. Ireland basically puts down an absolutely huge amount of dogs. And whereas in Sweden, they don't put down any. They don't put down any strays at all. So they thought that they could help the Irish situation. And 1,000 dogs a year, 1,000 dogs a year in Ireland go to Sweden, get rehomed in Sweden through this one charity. It's pretty disgusting, really. It's a disgrace that these 1,000 dogs would be put down here. I mean, I don't even know how many dogs are already put down in Ireland as it is, but these 1,000 dogs, we can't find homes for them here in Ireland, that we ship 1,000 dogs a year to Sweden. Why are we getting these dogs? Why are people still paying money at puppy farms and dodgy dealers, or Johnny from the local feckin' pub up the road? Why are people just treating like dogs, like they're just disposable commodities? It's disgusting. If Sweden can't, Sweden has enough that they can take ours. That's, you know, never mind that they can look after their own strays or their own rescue dogs, that they have the capacity to actually take more. That's rough. Anyway, we'll keep on going. We're probably going to be here another couple of hours before we hit the road. It's a 6-hour drive, or in and around 6 hours, to Pit Garden, I think is the name of it, in Germany. But that's where we get the ferry over to Denmark. It's only less than an hour. Okay, chat to you later. Doing it for the dogs. Bye-bye. I can take it to you, yeah. We'll go for it. Oh. Sorry?
Because you're longer than me.
Okay.
Longer and stronger. Oh.
Oh my word. I shall try. Okay, loopers. I only showered 2 hours ago and now I've got pee in my face. Hello, little one. Oh, okay, poor thing. Keep him up for a little while. As long as it takes. Okay. Come on, you. Come on, you nutters. You're already going the wrong way now. Now, this way.
Very, very at all.
Have I finished this van? Cool. I'll go get Amy. okay, Amy. Hello, my girl. There's my gorgeous girl. There's my gorgeous girl. There's my gorgeous girl. There's my girl. There's my girl. Sorry? Oh, did she? I was wondering why she didn't do a number two out there. We were walking for a while and I'm like, why are you not doing number two? Hello, my love.
So far, this entire trip has been port, shite, motorway, shite, port, shite, motorway, shite.
I want to show you how to do open and close. All you have to do is just...
Somewhere in Holland, on our way to Germany.
Hi, Andy. Hi, Andy. Hiya.
Open and close, open and close, open. I want to tell you a story.
Nami story, yo.
I want to tell you a story.
Nami story, yo.
What he be, yo?
He be dance.
What he be, yo?
He be dance.
Tell me what in then they call her.
Okay, it's 3 a.m. is our last one. Well, our puppies are in there. We'll try and do it quick because we've just done a 7-hour drive after the last 3 hours. Talking gibberish, the quicker we get these walked, the better. So it's 3 o'clock, chatting about an hour and a half. Bye.
Hello, my love. Hello, gorgeous. Hello, gorgeous. Hello, snoozly head. You're a bit snoozled.
I don't know how this looks. This is getting so tiring now. You can hear the dogs. So, it's been a 7-hour drive across country, across Holland and Germany to get to Puttgarden, where we are now. Ferry to Denmark goes every hour. On the hour, so we're going to try and get all the dogs just literally pee and poo and then back in. So if we're out of here by an hour and a half, that means we can be on the 5 o'clock ferry over to Denmark, and then that will take about an hour, so 6, and then there's about another 2 hours to the first stop where we release a few dogs, get rid of, unload half the dogs to a few owners, and then come on, Amy, come on, Amy, this way. Amy's not playing ball, she doesn't want to leave, and then it's another couple of hours after that, so maybe 11, 12 o'clock we'll be at our final destination. I haven't, still haven't really slept, so I'm up 48, 46 hours. I think I've had about 3 hours sleep in the last 46. So, anyway, I'm out of here. Bye-bye.
Okay. All good?
Yep. Okay, come on, puppies. Yeah. Don't be sniffing you. You just do something. Hold on, hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on, oh Jesus Christ, hold on, hold on, hold on, yes. Come on, come on, in you go.
There's a good girl. Shh, it's okay, Pat. It's okay, Pat.
Hold on. There we go. 10 past 4. Losing will to live. Nice moon up there. Lovely moon. I got a little. There we go. Let rip. It's always the small ones. So hopefully be out of here in about 20 minutes so we can make the 5 o'clock sailing. That'll get us over there at 6. And then 7, 8 maybe for the first stop. And then after about 9 or 10, 11, 12. So final stop around midday. And so that'll be a total of 48 hours done. So incredible journey, really. This is just nuts. I don't know how they do it. I really, really do not know how they do it. 3 times a month, every month, 1,000 dogs from Ireland. This is just nuts. I don't even know if I recorded some of the sound of the audio, or just the noise of the dogs, which is just, it's just mental. It's ear piercing. It's, you know, it's, you know, a lot of it's harrowing. It's, and this is what they do day in, day out. This is the job. Okay. Speak to you later. Okay, yeah. Jesus, yeah.
Well, here comes another dude.
Hello, my girl. Hello, my girl. Okay.
Come on. There you go. It's your new family. Here. It's your new mummy. It's your new mummy.
Hi. Hello, my friend. So nice.
What's that? A bit nervous.
Don't be afraid.
It won't take her long, trust me.
She will liven up, and I guarantee you, you will be. You'll be like, calm down. I promise you, she will open up so quickly, so quickly, because she's still just learning everything. Like, everything is still so new. This is your new mummy. This is your mummy. And we never really taught her a name, so you can give her another name. She doesn't really, you know, so whatever name suits you. So,
it's good.
Okay, because...
I like that. Short and easy.
So this is what it was all about. Showed the first pamphlets. Okay, take two. Try and be a bit more together. This is what it's about. So, all these families meeting up with their dogs. And, yeah, you can see people are just overwhelmed with the new additions to their family. And it's down to, like, incredible work of these guys, this charity and all the rescues in Ireland, who gave them a second chance. Should have got a little lady. God, she's only with us for 2 months. Anyway, I still haven't really slept anyway, so for 3 hours in the last 50 something hours, but it was all worth it. I'm so glad. I've just got a lovely mum, lovely family, so I don't know, dogs are amazing. All right. And that is that. It is 10:15 our time, 11:15 Swedish time. So, yeah, all the dogs are delivered. We're done.
Thank God.
Good job, man. It was fucking epic.
We can shake hands
because we are one. We've been bubbled. We're in a bubble. We've been bubbling for the last 2 days. So we're off now, off to the hotel, get something to eat, get some sleep. And then do it all again tomorrow to go back to Dublin.
With only two dogs this time.
So, yeah. I'm going to stop talking gibberish now. Talk to you all later. Bye.